Construction on Sesame is forcing big buses to take another route. We'll tell you more in a sec. Thanks for watching Bobcat Update. I'm Matt Wood.
And I'm Christina Koble. Also, Americans are beginning to feel the crunch of federal budget cuts. Texas State students are adjusting to new bus routes due to the construction along Sesame Drive. Students are now being dropped off at a new terminal on Woods Street for those who come from Post Road, Mill Street, Wonder World, and interurban routes. The Aquawina Springs and Bobcat Stadium routes are being redirected to Beretta Hall. Students arriving from Ranch Road 12 and LBJ are being dropped off at the quad bus loop as usual. Maps of the new bus routes have been placed around campus. The changes will remain in effect until the end of the spring semester. Yet another traffic change in San Marcos. A new stop sign has been put up on Ranch Road 12 at Houston Drive. The change will be especially helpful to residents living at the Retreat Apartments, a complex at the intersection. Anyone attempting to exit the apartments can see only a short distance, so the stop sign will make it safer. Other construction changes are planned for Ranch Road 12. A website has been created to provide up-to-date information on the construction progress.
Texas State is notorious for throwing some of the hottest pool parties, but this one is unlike any other. Taylor Henderson has more in this Bobcat update.
Some Texas State students decided to bring the nationally recognized organization Cans for a Cure to San Marcos. The organization seeks to further the fight for cancer awareness by raising money through collecting aluminum cans. Students held their first pool party at the University Heights 2 apartment complex Saturday to collect all of the cans that Texas State students used while enjoying some fun in the sun. Assistant Director Ashley Falcon says that losing loved ones to cancer motivated her to get involved.
My grandmother had breast cancer, so it's a way for me to give back to that part of the population that suffered from cancer. Just because she was a survivor and, you know, we donate all of our profit towards cancer research.
Executive Director James Kemp is excited about the turnout at the pool party this past weekend.
Definitely. It's a lot of fun. We had a lot of bins out, so yeah, it was definitely a success. We've done, like, I think about 4 events in the past year. Like, we did a barbecue cook-off, which was a lot of fun. A lot of free barbecue, which was cool.
If you're interested in helping out with the new San Marcos Cans for a Cure chapter, you can check out the group's Facebook page for more information.
With summer soon approaching, the weather permits more opportunities for the Cans for a Cure organization to continue raising awareness for cancer. For Bobcat Update, I'm Taylor Henderson.
The man accused of stabbing 14 people at a Texas college is undergoing psychological evaluation today. Dylan Quick, the 20-year-old suspect, told authorities that he has had fantasies of stabbing people since he was 8 years old and had been planning Tuesday's spree for some time. The stabbing happened at Lone Star College's Sci Fair campus near Houston and was ended by a group of students chasing Quick down and tackling him. Witnesses described the scene as chaotic and bloody. Quick is being charged with 3 counts of aggravated assault with a deadly weapon.
Jury selection has begun in the murder trial of Willie Jenkins. Jenkins is accused of the 1975 death of the 20-year-old San Marcos woman. According to an arrest affidavit, Cheryl Ann Norris was found dead at her apartment, Aquawina Springs Drive. She has been sexually assaulted, choked, and drowned. The Austin American Statesman reports that Jenkins has been in custody since December 2010, with bail set at $1 million. The Hayes County District Attorney is seeking the death penalty. Jury selection is expected to last several weeks.
Americans are starting to feel the effects of forced federal spending cuts known as sequester. That's according to a new CNN ORC International survey. The survey shows that more than two-thirds of Americans believe the cuts have severely or greatly affected the nation's economy, and 40% say the cuts have affected them personally. The cuts went into effect in March, cutting $85 billion from fiscal year 2013, which ends September 30th. The cuts were mandated by a 2011 agreement by Congress and the Obama administration that raised the federal debt ceiling.
The Republican Party appears to be split over whether or not to block gun legislation in the Senate. While more than a dozen GOP senators have said they plan to block the proposed bill from moving forward, several Republicans are now saying the public deserves to hear a debate over the controversial legislation. But Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell says he would favor a filibuster. An attempt to push the bill forward is expected tomorrow.
USA Today reports that ammo shortages are causing problems not just for individuals, but also for law enforcement agencies. For example, California police are advising officers not to go to the firing range as often for practice. One reason for the shortage is concern about the pending gun control legislation. Some people are buying larger than usual amounts of guns and ammo in case legislation results in tighter restrictions.
Next up, big changes in the weather today and tomorrow.
And Scott Panther is here to tell us all about it.
Since 1985, the Adopt a Highway program has tried to combat litter left on Texas highways, whether it's on purpose or by accident. In a single year, over 1 billion pieces of trash accumulate on Texas roadways. This equals to over 2.7 million pieces each day throughout the entire state. Texas is proud to have created the first Adopt a Highway program that is now adopted from countries all over the world and has more than 1.3 million volunteers nationwide. In 2012, more than 80,000 volunteers cleared 5,122 miles of highway, picking up 7 million pounds of trash, keeping our great state beautiful. If you or your organization are interested in helping keep Texas beautiful, contact your local Adopt a Highway representative or visit their website.
Welcome back. I'm Scott Panther with the weather. Current temperatures in San Marcos are sitting at 49 degrees. It's been kind of cloudy and rainy all day. Some unexpected chills after that warm front yesterday. Moving ahead to our Texas map, we have temperatures at about 84 in Amarillo and about 59 in El Paso. Looking at the Gulf in Brownsville, we have about 89 degrees, 41 in Dallas-Fort Worth area with some scattered showers up there, and about 46 in Austin. We look now at our temperature board for the entire United States, with 84 in Miami, 89 degrees in Washington, D.C., St. Louis was 77. They were having some rainstorms and possible snow. Chicago, about 40 degrees. And then Los Angeles, we have 76. And we also have more sunshine in Los Angeles and in Miami. In the upper Midwest portion of the United States, possible a lot of chance of snow, possible 8 to 12 inches of snow tonight. Some rain in Dallas-Fort Worth, as I mentioned, also in the Oklahoma and Kansas region. Also some chance of snow in the New York and New England region up there. And as I said, some more chances of rain up there in the Seattle region. Looking to our five-day forecast, we have a chance, or we have a low of 46 tonight, mostly cloudy temperatures tonight, a high of 47 tomorrow with partly cloudy, and mostly sunny skies tomorrow on Friday with a high of 81 degrees.
Well, I tell you, my dog and I were not expecting that cold, wet, rainy weather this morning. We were not too happy about it.
I know. I was on my way out the door, and I forgot my coat, obviously, since it was really chilly outside. So it was a really shock to me as well.
I'm going to have to get Scott's number so I can call him up and check his Twitter to see what the weather's going to be like.
I'll be sure to keep you guys updated a little bit.
Thank you, Scott.
Well, next up, is the post office going to suspend its Saturday delivery? We'll have the answer for you when we come back.
And now, Legoland now has a new themed hotel. We'll tell you more in a minute.
Visit the San Marcos Nature Center and learn about preserving our community's environment as well as all things native to San Marcos. From three-toed box turtles to green tree frogs, the center is home to over 20 animal species, native and exotic alike. Three large fish tanks house San Marcos river fish, including the spotted gar and the rainbow trout. Take a walk through the living library of native plant species and learn about the efforts to conserve the watershed ecosystem and its indigenous wildlife. Whether you come to learn more about San Marcos wildlife or are just looking for a relaxing stroll through pristine landscape, the San Marcos Nature Center has something for everyone. The Butterfly House exhibit features many different butterfly species in a closed environment for up-close observation. For more information on the San Marcos Nature Center, visit their website or Facebook page at facebook.com/thenaturecenter or call 512-393-8447.
The U.S. job market remains stagnant. The stock market goes up and then down. The economy continues to grow at a sluggish rate. But there are certain businesses that plug along regardless. They're considered recession-proof. Two examples are the medical field and funeral businesses. Economic whims don't seem to affect them because people get sick and die, no matter how the economy is performing in general. Expect jobs in certain fields to be plentiful in the years to come. Many baby boomers, after all, are approaching retirement age. Keeping your car running is costing people more than what they bargained for. The cost of car repairs is going up, according to a vehicle repair website called CarMD. Auto repair costs were up 10% in 2012, the biggest jump in 6 years. A reason for the hike in prices? Cars are getting older. The average car is now more than 11 years old. Last year's heat may also have been a factor.
The United States Postal Service will continue to deliver mail on Saturdays. The service stepped down from changing their current schedule of 6 days a week to five, saying Congress played a big part in the decision. A measure passed by Congress to fund the government operation despite the sequester barred the Postal Service from changing their schedule. The plan that would have taken effect this summer would have saved the service $6 billion a year. The bill was passed last year by the House to fund the service through the fiscal year, which ends September 30th.
The April 15th tax deadline is approaching quickly, and experts warn it's important to keep things honest. The Justice Department works closely with the IRS to prosecute tax cheats. And they say despite the forced spending cuts, the tax division along with the IRS expect to aggressively pursue tax violators. Government prosecutors have a 95% success rate in all civil and criminal cases litigated in the past year. The federal investigators are particularly focused on the use of foreign tax havens, which they believe can account for $100 billion annually.
Scientists are researching the correlation between stress levels and saliva. Haley Davis explains in this Bobcat update.
Some behavioral scientists are studying the measurement of stress that can be found in saliva. On Monday, Texas State hosted a presentation by Salivary Bioscience Research Center Director Douglas Granger.
Is there a way we can understand how people respond to stress in their environment that would enable us to help train people or teach them or coach them or better understand how they can respond to the environment?
Research is being done by the psychology department's salivary labs of multiple universities, such as Johns Hopkins, Arizona State, and Texas State University.
The whole purpose of this is to bring outside speakers in so that we can hear what they're doing, they can hear what we're doing, and try and form some connections to researchers outside of Texas State.
Researchers have found that the saliva samples collections show that physiology is often associated with behavior. Testing is done on one's environment and interactions to link saliva with stress. For Bobcat Update, I'm Haley Davis.
It's National Boys and Girls Club Week. Today, the San Marcos and Mitchell Center units opened their doors for free tours and firsthand experience of how the clubs can make a difference in young people's lives. About 4,000 clubs exist across America, providing a safe learning environment during non-school hours. The San Marcos unit has other activities planned for this week, including movie night on Thursday and a small carnival on Friday.
It's not too early in the year for some Bobcat football. The annual Maroon versus Gold spring game was played Saturday. The purpose of the game is to give fans the opportunity to see the team in action before the start of the season. Players and coaches are divided into two teams and play a full game, but with less than time per quarter. The 2012 senior class was also honored at halftime. Tailgating took place on the west side of the stadium, and kids were able to enjoy a fun zone with games.
Texas State is home to more than a few talented musicians, and there's one student in particular who's really making a name for himself. Morgan Wilson has more in this Bobcat update.
Managing school, work, and extracurriculars would be enough for most students. But try adding rapper, musician, creative visionary, and record label owner to the mix as well. Charles Enum, also known on stage as Charlie CB, is a transfer student who's following his passion for music.
I go through refining periods of all my raps. I want to make sure that it's still clever, but still powerful, has meaning, but still has simplicity to it.
Charlie is his own manager, and he's working hard to gain more fans.
They really, really digged it. And that's what that made me so happy, when you get the right recognition and people really enjoying what you do.
CB can't really put a label on his music.
I'm a varied person. I'm all over the place. But in the same way, it can be amazing chaos.
From his South by Southwest performance this year to his Battle of the Bands performance in Georges, CB's artistry hasn't gone unnoticed. You can find Charlie CB's music on his website or on iTunes. For Bobcat Update, I'm Morgan Wilson.
Parents have a new summer vacation destination for their kids now that Legoland has opened its own hotel in California. After years of anticipation, the three-story, 250-room hotel at the Legoland Resort in Carlsbad is finally open for business. Every room has a theme based on a popular Lego toy. Themes include Pirate, Adventure, and Kingdom. Visitors will be greeted by a Lego dragon created of 400,000 bricks guarding the hotel entrance and another 3,500 Lego models throughout the hotel. Wow, that's pretty impressive.
All those Legos, yeah.
Yeah, were you a Lego player growing up?
I was a big fan of Legos, and if I had a kid, I would definitely take him there. But I heard that Scott's a pretty big Lego fan still.
I've loved Legos all my life. I still play with Legos every now and then if I get the chance.
Absolutely, why not? Well, that's all we have for you this afternoon.
Thanks for watching Bobcat Update.